Hello everyone, welcome back to engineering chemistry class. The development in the field of science, engineering and technology naturally helps mankind and improve the comforts in life and enjoyment. Battery is one among them. These batteries are used in wristwatches, calculators, UPS, alarm signals, space vehicles, etc. In today's class, we'll discuss about what is battery and its components. Different types of batteries, operation of a battery, it may be charging and uncharging, construction working of lithium ion based batteries and their applications. Now we will discuss what is the battery. Battery is a device which converts chemical energy to electrical energy. What is cell? A cell designates a single unit. A battery is an arrangement of two or more cells, usually connected in a series or parallel or in both. Battery consists of three major components: anode, cathode, electrolyte. Anode, it contains active material which spontaneously taking part in oxidation reaction. Cathode, it contains active material which spontaneously taking part in reduction reaction. Electrolyte, it helps in ionic conduction, provides medium for transfer of ions from one compartment to other compartment. A separator, as the name indicates, is a physical barrier which separates anode compartment and cathode compartment. Usually, it is a polymeric membrane which prevents the mixing up of products formed at the anode and cathodes. This separator permeable for electrolytes in order to maintain ionic conductivity. In addition to this, terminals seal current collectors at anode and cathode, makes a cell complete. These batteries are classified into primary, secondary and reserve batteries. Primary batteries are those batteries in which cell reactions are not reversible. In primary batteries, once electroactive materials are converted to electro-inactive materials, they can't be reused. It must be discarded. In secondary batteries, cell reactions are not reversible. It consists of two processes, charging and discharging. During discharging, electroactive material converted to electro-inactive material, and during charging, electro-inactive material converted to electroactive material. Once current is applied in opposite direction. Reserve batteries. In this type of battery, one of the key components is separated from the rest of the battery prior to activation. Usually, electrolyte is the component that is isolated. When one of the key components is separated from remainder part of the cell, chemical reaction between the cell components, that is self-discharge, is prevented and the battery is capable of long-term storage. That is why reserve batteries are having more durability and less self-discharge. Now we will discuss operation of a battery. It consists of two parts. One is discharging and one more is charging. This is applicable for secondary batteries. Now we will discuss discharging. When anode and cathode of a battery connected to the load, redox reaction occurs spontaneously. The material stored in the cell which taking part in a spontaneous reaction are called as electroactive material. All material will not undergo reaction, only selective material which are undergo reaction, they are called as electroactive material. During the course of reaction, these electroactive materials are converted to electro-inactive materials. The load, suppose a bulb glows when electron flow towards. As you can see in the diagram, there is a movement of the electron from anode to cathode. During discharging, EMF of the cell gradually decreases. Charging. During discharging, electricity is passed in opposite direction from cathode to anode. See the direction of the current in the picture. During this process, EMF regains its original value. Lithium is an alkali metal which possesses low electrical potential, good conductivity, and light weight. For these reasons, lithiums are used in most of the batteries, like primary and secondary batteries. There are different types of lithium-ion batteries depend upon the choice of the electrolyte and positive electrode. These lithium batteries are classified as primary, which is not chargeable, and secondary batteries, which is chargeable. Example for lithium battery: lithium primary battery, lithium MnO2 battery, and secondary battery, lithium cobalt oxide battery. Now we will discuss lithium MnO2 battery construction. Anode is composed of lithium, whereas cathode contains heat treated MnO2. Electrolyte contains a mixture of lithium salts dissolved in organic solvents such as 1,2 dimethoxyethane and propylene carbonate. Now we will see the reactions in lithium MnO2 batteries. At anode, lithium undergoes oxidation. At cathode, tetravalent manganese gets reduced to trivalent manganese when lithium ion entering the MnO2 crystal lattice. Net reaction as shown in the picture. Now we will discuss secondary batteries in case of lithium ion batteries, that is lithium cobalt oxide batteries. Construction. In this type of battery, lithiated graphite is made as anode. Lithium intercalated transition metal oxide such as cobalt oxide made as cathode. Lithium salts such as lithium phosphorus hexafluoride or lithium boron tetrafluoride is mixed in organic solvents such as ethylene carbonate or propylene carbonate or dimethoxyethane or ether used as a solvent. When external voltage forces electrons through external circuits, lithium ions travel from lithium cobalt oxide electrode to graphite electrode. This is the net reaction. Let us see a few advantages. These lithium batteries have high energy density, long life, long self-discharge compared to other batteries. That is why they are used in cell phones, laptop, even in space vehicles also. Examination corner. The first question related to operation of a battery. Here we have to write what's happening during charging and discharging. During discharging, electroactive material is converted to electro inactive material, and during charging, electro inactive material is converted to electroactive material when current is applied in a opposite direction. Second question related to classification of cells like primary, secondary, and reserve batteries. We have to mention the example for each classification. The last question pertaining to construction working of lithium cobalt oxide batteries. We have to write charging and discharging reactions along with their applications. Summary. In today's class, we learned what is battery and its components and types of batteries. Operation of a battery is applicable for only secondary batteries like charging and discharging. And finally, we learned construction working of lithium ion based batteries.